Say, boys, have you heard tell of the Banshee?
What?
You haven't heard the word I've said, have you, Chris? How do you expect to grow up to be a big man if you can't even listen?
Yes, Grandpa.
What's a Banshee?
She's a dead soul.
Condemned to wander the earth as punishment for her sin. There's nothing scarier than the scream of the Banshee. Some said there's two types of Banshee. There's a young one who's all pale and beautiful. Now she's wearing these long, flowing, silvery garments. She'd be like watching over her family, warning them of death and doom. But it's her screeching cry that'll get you. Turning the air freezing cold. Scaring the living daylights out of you. Then you know that someone close to you is dead. But she warns of death.
Well, Grandpa, it's getting late.
You'll be back in the morning, then, eh? I could deal with some wood chopped.
Yeah, sure.
Aye, all right. Take care.
Aye.
Safe journey home.
Hey, Chris. You think banshees are real?
No. It's just another one of the old man's stories. Besides, remember how I was telling us last week about the Fae and their powers? Seen fairies running around anywhere?
No.
Well then, they're just stories, not real.
To tell us one of his stories again.
You know, your father wants you to get back here in time for dinner. So next time, you two need to leave earlier and not wait. Anyway, go ahead and get ready for dinner. Your father's running late tonight, too. And no video games.
Good evening, John. How was your day?
Busy. Head office call today, and we have to lay off more people. Right now, I'm just trying to figure out how to save money without losing too many people.
I'm sorry you had a bad day. But on the bright side, Kasha called. She got her ticket, and she should be here by Monday morning.
Well, that's one good bit of news. Smells good, Patty. I want to thank you again for all your help. I don't know what I would have done without you here looking after the boys. After Susan's death,
you were doing a great job, John. She would be really proud of you.
Jaden seems to be holding up pretty well. But Chris, he's pulling away, and I don't know what to do.
3 years isn't very long. Give him some more time.
Yeah, you're right. Sometimes I feel as if everything is going out of control.
Well, Kasha will be home soon, and I'll bet that cheers everything up. Meanwhile, I need to go. I'll see you tomorrow.
Thanks, Patty. I'll see you tomorrow. So what did you and Jane do today?
We helped around at Grandpa's house.
Yeah, he told us a story about the Banshee, too. Kind of freaky.
Well, your grandpa could tell quite a tale. He curled my toes a time or two growing up.
I've got some good news. Kasha will be here for a visit in the next few days.
Cool, but wish she could stay.
Well, your sister still has 2 more years to go before she graduates. Then she'll be back for a while.
I know. I just miss her.
I miss her, too.
Grandpa wants us to come back tomorrow. He needs some wood chopped.
Well, that's fine, but make sure you guys are back here on time, huh? I don't like you running around after dark. I heard on the news there was another shooting at the mall.
Well, it's not like we're going to be at the mall. And besides, Jaden's almost 13 and I'm almost 18. We're not kids anymore.
All right, just make sure you're home before dark, huh? And bring a flashlight, just in case. Keep your old man happy.
Jade, help me pick up these pieces of wood and put them in the shed. I don't want to be here all night.
They're too heavy, Chris. You need to cut them up smaller. I keep dropping them.
Come on, Jade. You don't expect me to do this all by myself, do you?
I'm just tired. We've been doing this all day.
Okay. Well, why don't you go see if Grandpa has anything left he wants us to do, and I'll finish up here. Hey! Hey, you!
Chris, watch where you're going.
Bye, Grandpa.
Chris, wait. Why are you running? It's not happening over at Grandpa's.
It's nothing. I just don't want to get in trouble again. Dad's gonna be pissed. Let's just go.
What's that?
I don't know.
Over there.
Hey. You need some help?
I don't like this, Chris.
Let's get out of here.
Kasha?
That's not Kasha. She's in England.
No, it's Kasha.
Let's just go.
What happened? Are you okay?
Dad, there was a woman in the woods crying.
It was the Banshee.
That's enough. No more stories.
It's not a story. It's true. We saw her.
Dad, is everything okay?
Oh, boys.
Chris, Jay and I have got something to tell you. Kasia died this morning.
What happened?
Your sister was killed in a car accident. We just got a call from the dean.
But Dad, the woman in the woods, she looked like Kasia.
Stop it! There's no such thing as ghosts.
She wasn't a ghost. She was a banshee, just like Grandpa said.
Enough. I don't want to hear about your grandfather's stories. They're just crap. Your sister is dead.
No, they're true. I saw an old woman today by the river, just like Grandpa said.
What?
Grandpa said an old banshee would sit by the river washing the clothes of the dead. I think we need to go back to Grandpa's.
No! You two need to stay away from that old man for a while. I don't need him filling your heads with all that bullshit.
It's not bullshit. We saw it ourselves.
Now's not the time for this. Go to your rooms!
So we stand here together to remember a wonderful young woman who was called home early. The tragic death of Kasia McPherson. Let us pray. O God, by thy mercy, rest is given to the souls of the faithful.
Be pleased to Dad, bless this grave.
Why didn't Grandpa come?
Appoint your holy Shh, angels Jay, to guard it.
Never mind him. I'm going to have a long talk with your grandpa when we get back.
Who is buried here, so that with thy saints she may rejoice in thee forever. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed be the Lord of Israel, for he hath visited and redeemed his people, and hath raised up a mighty salvation for us. The oath which he swore to our forefather Abraham, and he would give us, that we were being delivered out of the hands of our enemies, might serve him without fear. Through the tender mercy of our God, whereby the day spring from on high hath visited us, to give light to them that sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, and guide our feet in the way of peace. Amen.
It's her screeching cry that'll get you. Turning the air freezing cold. Scaring the living daylights out of you. Then you know that someone close to you is dead. For she warns of death.
Grandpa.
Grandpa?
He's dead.
Breath on me.